back to biome. In the last video, we have discussed about the taxonomy, systematics and the classification. Now, today, we learn about the taxonomical hierarchy. Now, यहाँ पे पहले जाने के लिए कुछ एग्जाम्पल ले लेते हैं. कैसे? हम लोग के चारों साइड में बहुत सारे ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैं. कुछ ऑर्गेनिजम्स के अंदर में कुछ सिमिलैरिटीज हो सकता है, डिसिमिलैरिटीज भी हो सकता है. तो हम लोग को क्या करना है, जो सारा ऑर्गेनिजम्स का एक ही साथ एक ही सिमिलैरिटीज है उसको एक साथ रखना है, जो ऑर्गेनिजम्स के साथ कोई डिसिमिलैरिटीज है उसको अलग रखना है. तो यहाँ पे कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी क्रिएट होता है. तो इस क्रिएट को इजी करने के लिए हम लोग को क्या करना पड़ेगा, कुछ सिस्टमेटिक अरेंजमेंट करना पड़ेगा. कैसे? चलो कमोन एग्जाम्पल ले लेते हैं. सबके घर में किचन है, तो किचन में हम लोग एक साथ में एक जगह में मसाला रखते हैं. एक मसाला पॉट होता है, तो उसके अंदर में छोटा छोटा देखोगे ग्रुव रहता है. तो इसमें डिफरेंट 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 टाइप्स का मसाला रहता है, मगर सब एक साथ में रहता है. मगर एक साथ में रहते हुए भी एक दूसरे से सेपरेशन होता है, तो एक दूसरे से मिल नहीं जाता है ना. तो यहाँ पे जो ऑर्गेनिज्म हम लोग का प्रेजेंट है, सारा ऑर्गेनिज्म एक ही साथ एक ही बायो में एक ही इकोसिस्टम और एक ही वर्ल्ड में प्रेजेंट है. इवन दो दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द सेम इकोसिस्टम बट दे आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईच अदर, बट दे आर लिंक्ड विद ईच अदर बट दे आर ऑल्सो डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईच अदर. तो ऐसे हम लोग को इकोसिस्टम में भी होता है, एनवायरमेंट में भी होता है. तो यहाँ पे हम लोग को क्या करना पड़ेगा, यहाँ पे हम लोग का जो टैक्सोनॉमिकल हायरार्की है, ये टैक्सोनॉमिकल हायरार्की कैसे आता है और इसको आने के बाद हम लोग कैसे इसको समझ सकते हैं, कोशिश करेंगे हम लोग जानने के लिए. तो डिफिकल्ट पोर्शन है मगर इजी तरीके का हम लोग जानेंगे तो अच्छे से हम लोग समझ जाएंगे. सो चलो शुरू करते हैं. तो यहां पे हम लोग क्या करेंगे, सो द टैक्सोनॉमिकल हायरार्की. इन द टैक्सोनॉमिकल हायरार्की फर्स्ट वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द टैक्सोनॉमिकल कैटेगरी. सो द टैक्सोनॉमिकल कैटेगरी मीन्स सारा ऑर्गेनिजम्स, यहाँ पे पिक्चर में ड्रॉइंग किया था देख लिए थे, सारा ऑर्गेनिजम्स एक ही जगह में है मगर तभी भी एक दूसरे से सेपरेशन है. तो यहाँ पे हम लिखे हैं टैक्सोनॉमिकल कैटेगरी. अब एक टैक्सोनॉमिकल एक ही टैक्सोनॉमिकल कैटेगरी का द टोटल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज एक्चुअली इज कॉल्ड एज अ टैक्सोनॉमिकल हायरार्की. सो देयर व्हाट इज द टैक्सोनॉमिकल कैटेगरी, द ईच रैंक इज कॉल्ड एज टैक्सोनॉमिकल कैटेगरी. ऑल्सो इट इज ईच रैंक इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ टैक्सन. So what is the taxon and the taxonomical category? Both are same. So each one, the kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species, the each one is also called as taxonomical nomical category and also taxon is the same thing. Okay. Now the arrangement of taxonomical category in a stepwise manner it's called as a taxonomical hierarchy. Now in a taxonomical hierarchy, when you move from the downside to upward, when it moves from downside to upward, we'll get a larger aspect. Okay, so these are the smaller aspect and the higher one is the larger aspect. Clear? So matlab yahan pe dekhenge ye jo taxonomical category hai, so ये टैक्सोनॉमिकल कैटेगरी सारा चीज को कवर करेगा, इसका एस्पेक्ट दैट इज ब्रॉडर एंड दिस वन द लोएस्ट वन दिस एस्पेक्ट इज स्मॉलर. करेक्ट? ओके. नाउ हियर दिस टैक्सोनॉमिकल हायरार्की, हु हैज गिवन फर्स्ट दिस टैक्सोनॉमिकल हायरार्की, फर्स्ट गिवन बाय द लिनियस. ओके, सो हियर इफ यू काउंट हाउ मेनी टोटल टैक्सोनॉमिकल कैटेगरीज यू विल गेट, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So total 7 taxonomical category you will get. But the Linnaeus, he has also given some taxonomical category first. So but what are those? Short form is Koch VS. So what is the Koch VS? So C means class, O means order, G means genus, V means variety and S means species. So what about the other missing two? So what are the missing? The first missing is our kingdom, okay, and the next is the family. So later, few biologists came. They also included other taxonomical categories. So what are those? So they included K, F, and also S. So the K means kingdom. Okay. F means family. And also subspecies. They also included who? The other biologist. First, the Linnaeus included this five. Later, other biologists, they included these three. So these are the subspecies. Okay, clear? Now, here in front of us, there are the total seven taxonomical categories are present. What are those seven taxonomical categories? So if we read those seven taxonomical categories from the higher peak to the lower one, so we get kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. So it's very difficult to remind in this order. So what we can do? We can learn one short trick. So by that one, easily we are able to remind that. So what are that short trick? The short trick is keep pot clean or family get sick. These are the basic short trick to remind the all seven taxonomical categories. So let's explain this. So this K represent kingdom, P represent phylum, C represent class, O represent order, F represent family, G represent genus, S represent species. Is it short trick? Asan hua? Chalo. Ab isko hum log kya karte hain? Each taxonomical category we have to explain. But when you start explaining the each taxonomical category, we should start from the lower point. Why? Because this is a smaller aspect. Okay. Here the characters, it will be distinct and it will be prominent. So we'll first explanation will start from the species. So here I have written that all taxonomical category in stepwise. Why? Because here it is coming from the lower side to upper side. Okay. And as a result, from a particular individual character, it will come to a larger wide aspect. So first we going to explain the species. So once we come to the species, in case of the species, what is the species? So the species means these are the group of organism similar in structure, but they are reproductively isolated from each other. Difficult word hai, achcha se samajhte hain. So what is that species? What I told, they are group of closely related species. Okay, even though they are closely related, but sexually they are isolated from each other. Ek example leke isko samajhte hain. Like if you think about the scientific name of the tiger and the lion, what is that scientific name? The tiger scientific name is Panthera tigris, and lion scientific name is Panthera leo. So over here, the first that is genus and second one that is species. Now here, if you check, this species and this species is completely different. But even though the tiger and the lion, in many aspects they have similarities. तुम लोग देखोगे तो tiger और lion का करीब करीब ये लोग का fooding habit, habitat, nature करीब करीब एक ही होता है. दोनों ही carnivore से meat eating animal है. तो दोनों के अंदर में बहुत सारे similarities है. But even though similarities are there, but reproductively they are separated. So tiger never going to meet with the lion, and lion also never going to meet with the tiger naturally. Okay, but in artificially we can do. When the tiger and the lion, there is a crossbreed is there, it's called as a liger. But it is not possible in normal nature. Now, so that is called as a species. So what I told, once is a species, so one species, they are very much closely related group of organism. Now this species, it's also have two types. So what are the types of the species? So the first type of the species is polytypic species. Polytypic species, and second one is the monotypic species. So what are these polytypic species and the monotypic species? NEET exam में इसको पूछा जाता है, अच्छे से समझ लेना तुम लोग. So poly, poly means multiple. That means here this species have again another subspecies or variety. So here what happens? This species again have some subspecies or variety. Okay, what are the examples? With example we can understand that. Common example, if you take the scientific name of the cabbage and the cauliflower. So what is the scientific name of the cabbage? So here scientific name of the cabbage is Brassica oleracea capitata. Brassica oleracea capitata. So this is the scientific name of cabbage. And what is the scientific name of cauliflower? That is Brassica oleracea botrytis. So this is cauliflower. Now if you look over here, so this Brassica, this is genus, oleracea is species. So here both this genus has same species, but even though have the same species, as I told over here, the species have different variety. So here the variety is capitata, and here variety is botrytis. Okay, so the polytypic species means over here the species have again subspecies or variety. So first example we have taken Brassica oleracea capitata, next example we have taken Brassica oleracea cauliflower. So here the botrytis and the capitata, these are the variety. Okay, next, what is means by the monotypic species? So once we come to the monotypic species, mono means single. That means this species, they doesn't have any further subspecies. So uska example kya ho sakta hai? Hum log simple le sakte hain, homo sapiens. Homo sapiens. So the homo sapiens, kabhi suna hi nahi hai sapiens ke baad kuch hai. So that is, this species have only single. Okay, there is no further variety. So homo sapiens only. So this is the type of the monotypic species. So this is the all about the species. Okay, clear? So next we'll move into genus. So what is a genus? So the genus means this is a group of, remind it, this is a group of closely related species. This is a group of closely related species. So that is called as a genus. So what is the definition of the genus? So the genus is a group of closely related species. That is called as a genus. ऐसे हो सकता है. तो हम लोग एक एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं, लाइक साइंटिफिक नेम ऑफ टाइगर. व्हाट इज द साइंटिफिक नेम ऑफ द टाइगर? सो द साइंटिफिक नेम ऑफ द टाइगर इज पैंथेरा Panthera, tigris. Scientific name of that lion is Panthera leo, and scientific name of the leopard is Panthera pardus. So these are the, now if you look over here, this all tiger, lion and leopard. So they all have same genus. What is that same genus? That genus is Panthera. That means क्या हो गया, ये जो leopard, lion और tigris, और means tiger, ये तीनों organism जो है एक दूसरे से बहुत मिलता जुलता है. Okay? In terms of external characteristics features, some internal characteristics features, in many aspects they are very much close related. So that's why the closely related species togetherly we call them as genus. So that's why this genus is Panthera, Panthera, Panthera. The all three species, they have the same genus, that is Panthera. Clear? So next, what happens? But if you think about that one, the Panthera, Panthera means the tiger or lion or leopard. So same way, if you think about the dog, so their genus definitely it will not be same. So that's why next category is the family. So what is the family? So the family is the group of closely related genus. Group of closely related genus. Common example, the Panthera tigris, Panthera leo and Panthera leopard. So they all three are belongs to the same family. The family name is the Felida. And in this Felida family also, the cat also belongs, correct? So that's why ये तीनों के साथ जो cat का जो family है, that is also Felida. इस एक common dialogue हम लोग तो सुनते ही हैं, okay? Tiger का मौसी कौन है? नहीं तो बिल्ली. क्यों? क्योंकि ये जो दोनों organism है, ये दोनों एक ही family में belong करता है. What is the family? That family is the Felida. So what is the Canida? So the Canida is the family of dog. So that means what happens here, we got the family means the group of closely related genus. That means if you think the tiger's family and the cat, they are belongs to the same family, but the dog, it doesn't belongs to the same family. So the dog's family is the Canidae, correct? So that is a family. Same way we are getting the order. So what is the order? So the order is the group of closely related family. If you think about the tiger, lion, leopard, cat and dog, the all five organisms in nature, they are carnivore. So that's why these all five organisms, they belongs to order Carnivora, correct? So what is the order? So the order is the group of closely related family. Next is the class. So how can I explain the class? So the class means it's a group of closely related order. If you think about the tiger, cat, deer, lion, leopard, okay, they all are by nature, they are mammalia because they have mammary gland. So that's why they are mammalia. They are not reptile. They are not reptilia. They are not avis. They are mammalia. So, what is the class? It's a group of closely related order. Next, if it comes to the phylum. So, if you look into the phylum. So, the phylum means a group of closely related class. So, now here, the phylum, if you think about. So, this all mammals, definitely they are in their embryonic conditions. They have notochord, nerve cord. And that's why the characteristics features of the chordata. And what is the kingdom? So the kingdom is the highest taxonomical category. Okay. So, and we can also say that one, it's a group of closely related phylums. And the phylum in case of the plant, we are using division. Okay. In case of the animal, we are using phylum. And in case of the plant, we are using division. And what is the kingdom? So this kingdom, They are the group of closely related phylum. And we already know how many kingdoms we have. According to the R.H. Whittaker, we have the five kingdom of classification. Correct? We learned over there the kingdom Animalia, kingdom Plantae, kingdom Fungi, kingdom Protista. Okay, so many are there. We have learned about that five kingdom of classification. So here, if you think about that one, so kingdom, it might be Animalia, it might be Plantae, it might be Fungi. Okay, many other things. Correct? So these are the taxonomical total category. Now over here, we took one example and we'll explain the total taxonomical hierarchy or taxonomical category in detail way. So here we have taken the mammal or human. So here, if you take the human and if you are going to classify or if you're going to distribute the human on taxonomical category, so what will be the arrangement in case of the human? So the human, if you come there, so the kingdom will be definitely not Plantae, Animalia. What will be the phylum? Phylum will be Chordata. Why? Because the human in their embryonic conditions, they have the naphchord and notochord. Okay? But not only the human have the naphchord and notochord, many other mammals also have the naphchord and notochord. So here it's a larger aspect. And this is also a largest aspect. Then if you come to the class, so the class will get the mammalia. Because if you come to the mammalia, so those are the non-mammals. That means if you come there, the avis, reptilia, chondrichthyes, osteichthyes, amphibia, this group are separated completely from this category. So here we come to the mammalia. Once we come to the mammalia, so mammalia we comes to the order that is a primata. So the primata, definitely the human, okay, our gorilla, they comes under the primata. That means, see over here, as we are coming down, the characteristics features it's become narrower and more specific. Next, the family. So the family will be Homunidae, and the genus is Homo, and the species is Sapiens. So as we are moving down from the kingdom towards the species, the characteristics features become more distinct and more specific. And as we move from the downside to upward, as we move from the downside to upward, the characteristics features, it will become broader and broader aspect. As we are getting over the here, the Animalia. तो एनिमल के मतलब क्या है? जितना सारा एनिमल है सब एक साथ में हम लोग रिप्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं, तो सारे एनिमल के अंदर में सारा एनिमल कॉर्डेट नहीं हो सकता है, तो कॉर्डेट सेपरेट हो गया, जितना कॉर्डेट सेपरेट है उसके अंदर में सारा कॉर्डेट मैमल्स नहीं हो सकता है, मैमल्स के छोड़ के भी दूसरा ग्रुप भी हो सकता है. ओके, फिर मैमल्स के अंदर में सब क्या होता है, प्राइमेट भी हो सकता है, नॉन प्राइमेट भी हो सकता है, तो यहाँ पे प्राइमेट अलग हो गया. फिर प्राइमेट के अंदर में कुछ कार्निवोरा भी हो सकता है, कुछ नॉन कार्निवोर भी हो सकता है, कुछ ओमनिवोर भी हो सकता है. तो यहाँ पे जो ह्यूमन का हो गया होमोनिडी हो गया, और होमोनिडी के बाद हम लोग जेनस और स्पीसीज मिला. ओके, बट हियर दिस इज नॉट द अल्टीमेट थिंग्स. इन बिटवीन आल्सो वी आर गेटिंग द सम सब डिविजन्स और सब रैंक आल्सो वी आर गेटिंग. कॉमन एग्जांपल्स, इन बिटवीन आल्सो सम इंटरमीडिएट कैटेगरी आल्सो वी आर गेटिंग. सो व्हाट आर दोस इंटरमीडिएट कैटेगरी? सो हियर आफ्टर द किंगडम वी कैन आल्सो गेट सुपर फाइलम. After the phylum, we can also get subphylum. After subphylum, we can also get superclass. After superclass, we can get subclass. After subclass, we can also get superorder. After superorder, we will get order. After order, we can also get suborder. After suborder, we can also get subfamily. Like this, it can go. So these are called as intermediate categories. These are called what? Intermediate categories. Okay, in higher class you learn about those intermediate categories. Okay, clear? So today we'll learn up to this much. In the next video we'll discuss about the taxonomical aids. Clear? So if you like this video, okay, please give a big thumbs up and subscribe our channel. Till then, thank you and goodbye and stay well.